more white man lie.
You, O God of Israel,
praises sit on all sides. All praises sit on all sides.
O God of Israel,
A lot of things going on. We got a lot to cover today. I need y'all to keep me abreast of the time. But before we get into the news, I do want to touch on the new revelation that the Most High has brought out to us. Some of you may be aware of it, some of you may not. I came across this over a year ago. I showed it to Bishop Kanai, and he really didn't want to deal with it till we went to
where we go?
Ghana. So while we were in Ghana, he decided to go over the scriptures, and then he said, okay, he said he sees something. So then we shared it with the deacons. Now, this has been time. So we didn't rush to any conclusions on this. Deacon Ithon was perplexed for a moment. So we said, well, you give us a scripture to set us right, brother. So all praise to the Most High. So we all came on one accord. So that's how you do things in Israel. You got to wait till the body is on one accord before you bring something out. It's not about me. It's not about any one man or any two. It's about us as a body. I want to open up with Genesis 1, 14, 15. I want to put the picture on the screen first. Can we put the scripture picture on the screen? Now, some of you on Facebook, y'all know who y'all are. You know how some sisters like to argue at home? Well, you believe it or not, you have brothers with that same spirit.
Not the brothers.
Brothers. Right, Ruben? Leon, right? Y'all know what I'm talking about. I just got to argue. I like to argue. Don't argue. All you have to do, one thing to say to them, what scripture says the new moon is black. That shuts everything down. So now let's open up with Genesis chapter 1, verse 14 and 15.
Here we go. The book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 14.
Uh-huh.
And God said, let there be light.
And God said, let there be light.
In the firmament.
Of the heavens. Come on.
To divide the day from the night.
Uh-huh.
And let there be signs and for seasons and for days and years. Mm-hmm. And let them be for light in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth.
Notice the operative word, light, 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 light. Now, what this is this creation we're reading about? Okay, so regarding the moon, well, read the next verse.
Verse 16, and God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also.
So now we're discussing the moon. So this is the creation of the sun and the moon is what we're discussing. The greater light is the sun that ruled the day. The lesser light is the moon to rule the night. Correct? So this is the first time the moon is on the scene, and it gave what?
Light.
There you go. This is day one. The moon gave light. It did not say the moon gave forth darkness. Right. The moon gave light. Is that right or wrong?
Okay. Right. It didn't say that the lesser light, it didn't say that it was dark.
Right.
It said that it ruled the night.
Exactly.
Light ruled the night.
Exactly. So if you look up on the screen up there, I hope everybody can see it. According to Esau's calendar, which we've all been following, if you see where it says new, it's when the moon is dark. Right. And so that's what we've been following. I've been in truth almost over 20, about 27 years, 28, something like that. I can't remember. But we've been following that because that's what we were taught. But we're going to see what the Bible says. Real quick, Abby, not Abigail. Captain Reimer, give me Romans chapter 3. This is what all y'all got to remember. Romans chapter 3, verse 1 and 2, I think it is. Is that what I want?
Okay. The book of Romans chapter 3, verse 1. What advantage then hath the Jew? Or what profit is there of circumcision? Much every way. Chiefly, because that unto them were committed the oracles of God.
Unto us was committed the Bible. The oracles of God means the Bible. Read.
For what if some did not believe?
What if some of you didn't believe? Go ahead.
Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
Is your unbelief going to change the prophecies of the Bible? The answer is no. Go ahead.
God forbid.
The answer is no. Read.
Yea, let God be true.
Here comes, let God be true.
But every man a liar.
That means let the Bible be true. But what comes out of your own personal mind, let it be a lie. You must come out of the book. And it's going to say that. Go ahead.
As it is written.
How we got to teach? Read that again.
As it is written.
As it is written. Go ahead.
That thou mightest be justified in thy saying.
So whatever we teach, it must be according as it is written. So for a long time, we've been saying the new moon is dark, but never really pulling a scripture that said so. So we sat down and we said, let's really examine the scriptures about what God says the moon. So thus far, Genesis 1, 14, 15, 16, it says the moon is what?
A light.
Now, let's go to 2 Ezra 6, verse 45.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 6, verse 45. Upon the fourth day, thou commandest that the sun should shine, and the moon give her light.
Was that it?
And the stars should be in order.
So Ezra's revealing what was revealed to Moses. Upon the fourth day, thou commandest that the sun should shine and the moon give her light. This is the beginning. This is the new moon. If you didn't know what moon this was, this is the... In the beginning, it's always called a new. It's the sun was new. The moon was new. The sun gave light. The moon gave light. Do y'all get that?
Yes, sir.
Basic.
Go ahead, y'all. You got to read that again. Read it again.
The book of 2 Ezra, chapter 6, verse 45. Upon the fourth day, thou commandest that the sun should shine.
That the sun should shine. That the sun should shine.
And the moon give her light.
And the moon give her light in the first day. So it's telling you, like we're going to read the other scriptures, that tells you that the month gets its name from moon. And that it's the beginning of the month, and you have to be able to see it in order to determine that the new month is in.
Let's go to Sirach, which is Ecclesiastes 40. Oh, yes, I thought I got something. I'm sorry.
Read the next verse.
Verse 46. And gavest them a charge to do service unto man that was to be made.
Now, do these ordinances give charge when you can't see them? No, they give charge and you're able to see them. The sun rises, the moon gives light, and the stars get their light. That's why when people sail on the sea, they look at the North Star, the brightest star, to determine where to go. If it's like every other light, you wouldn't know if it's the North Star. There's certain constellations that are brighter than others, so you're able to know where to go. That's the stars following their order. The moon gives this order. We know when the moon is full or light, that's the beginning of the month. Likewise, when the sun rises, we know it's daytime. It's common sense. Not the moon's order is we can't see it. How can give you an order you can't see it? What order is that?
So what did we do before the internet when we couldn't Google it?
Right.
We out there looking like this. There ain't no moon out here. I guess it's the new moon. Now watch this. Sirach 43. Ecclesiastes 43. And let's start at verse 6.
Sirach 43, verse 6. He made the moon also to serve in her season for a declaration of times and a sign of the world. For the moon is the sign of feasts.
From the moon is the sign of feasts. Watch this.
A light that decreaseth in her perfection.
Now, verse 7 is what we want to really ponder on. Read verse 7 again.
from the moon is the sign of feast.
So the moon gives you the sign of feast. That's according to Leviticus 23. It gives you all the feast there, so you got to base it upon the moon. Now watch this.
A light.
Stop right there. A light. So God tells you the beginning of the moon is a light. So when we look up on the, we got this little lunar thing up here. Okay, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 images of the moon having light. One is a waxing crescent. One is the first quarter. One is a waxing gibbous, full, waning, third quarter, waning crescent. Now, if y'all see the waning, y'all see the waning crescent, right? Hello? Bottom right. Okay. That is the one where Amalek says the first crescent is the new moon. Now, all of us that came from the old, the original ISUPK, were taught that the new moon was the black. Again, we taught that the new moon was black, right there where it says new. And Amalek, so-called Jews, teach that the waning crescent is the new moon. Okay, which one is correct? Now we're seeing that it's really that full moon, and we're going to read the scripture to find out. Read that scripture again, Captain.
The book of Sirach, chapter 43, verse 7. From the moon is the sign of feasts, a light that decreases.
Stop. It says first it's a light, then it says that decreases. Oh, okay. So it's a light, and it begins with a light, and it decreases. Okay, so that's not that waning crescent there, because that's from that black new moon. I want you to look. Remember going clockwise. From the black new moon to the next waning, the light is increasing. Do y'all see that? That's it. So that can't be it. The Bible says the moon is a light that decreases. Okay. So now when you go to the full moon, do you see when you go up, waxing? Do y'all see it decreasing? It's decreasing now when you start with the full. Right. So now go back, Captain.
From the moon is the sign of feasts, a light that decreaseth in her perfections.
In her perfection. So it was, the light was originally perfect. When? Where is it perfect at? The full moon. The full. That's perfect. Then it decreases. You see that when you go clockwise? Y'all, everybody see that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I just want to make sure I ain't going crazy. Because you have people on Facebook, not y'all up in here. I ain't talking about y'all now. Brother said, no, the moon increases, then decreases. So I'm reading this stupid comment. That ain't what the Bible said. The Bible says a light that decreaseth in her perfection. Watch this, verse 8.
Verse 8. The month is called after her name.
That's where the word month comes from. It comes from moon. Go ahead.
Increasing wonderfully in her changing.
Then it says increasing wonderfully in her changing. So what came first, increasing or decreasing? Decreasing. So it's a light that decreases first, then increases. Now y'all see it. So from the full, it begins to decrease. You get to the moon, you don't see it, the new. Then it begins to increase. Y'all see it when you go clockwise? Everybody see that? Oh, just got to make sure I'm not going crazy up in here. Am I going crazy? Everybody understand?
No, Bishop, the spirit is on you, brother.
All right. Read on. What verse you at? Verse 8. One more again.
The month is called after her name, increasing wonderfully in her changing, being an instrument of the armies above, shining in the firmament of heaven.
Y'all see that word shining? Shining. The moon is shining in the firmament of heaven. Not darkness. Not we. Lord, Lord, we the angels up here, but we can't see it. The Lord, the moon is shining. But that's not what they say on earth. White man taught them is black. Read on.
Verse 9. The beauty of the heaven, the glory of the stars, an ornament giving light in the highest places of the Lord.
Mm. Go ahead.
At the commandment of the Holy One, they will stand in their order and never faint in their watches.
So now from there, let's go to chapter, in the same book, Ecclesiastes, go to chapter 39, verse 12.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 39, verse 12. Yet have I more to say, which I have thought upon. For I am filled as the moon at the full.
So it's letting you know, again, the moon, at that's when it's bright. Okay? So, read verse 13.
Hearken unto me, ye holy children, and bud forth as a rose growing by the brook of the field.
So now it compares it like, what does that say? A bud forth as a rose, like when it begins to come out, when it grows. So it's comparing the two, the moon with that bud of a rose. From there, go to chapter 50, same book, chapter 50, verse 5 through 8.
Ecclesiasticus, chapter 50, verse 5. How was he honored in the midst of the people?
Now, he is Simon, the high priest. He's making reference to Simon the high. When you start from verse 1, look at verse 1 so we can see.
Verse 1, Simon the high priest, the son of Onias, who in his life repaired the house again, and in the days fortified the temple.
So Simon became high priest. The temple was rebuilt, fortified. Jump down to verse 5.
Verse 5.
Was that the verse? Yeah, verse 5. That's it.
Verse 5. How was he honored in the midst of the people in his coming out of the sanctuary?
So now you got to imagine Simon the high priest coming out of the temple, out of the sanctuary. Go ahead.
Verse 6. He was as the morning star in the midst of a cloud and as the moon at the full.
So they're showing you how glorious he looked. They said he's like the moon at the full when it comes out. So it's letting you know when Simon came out the temple, was he half-dressed? Did he have just one boot on? He looked glorious from head to toe. The doors, oh, you got to imagine it. You got the temple. You got Israel. Now, we didn't do things busted. You got to imagine like a coronation. When a king comes forth, you got the trumpeters. You got the drummers. Y'all know what I'm talking. Can you imagine what I'm talking about? Some of y'all look confused up in here. So now, likewise, with Simon the high priest, he's ordained high priest. The temple doors open. All Israel are standing there to applaud and give praise. He comes forth. They said him coming out is like the moon at the full. Glorious in his perfection. Everybody understand that? Not with half a garment on. What verse was that?
That was verse 6.
Read on.
Verse 7. As the sun shining upon the temple of the Most High.
So now it went from the moon to the sun. Shining. Everybody see that? Go ahead.
Upon the temple of the Most High. And as the rainbow giving light in the bright clouds.
So when a rainbow comes out, is it half a rainbow? Is it a quarter of a rainbow? Or is it a full rainbow? It's full. So now the writers, our forefathers, comparing the moon, the sun, and the rainbow. And it's the same thing that we read about in, where was we just reading? Sirach 43. When you read the whole chapter, it goes from the sun to the moon to the stars to the rainbow in the fullness of their glory. Not like you see over there where it's black and you can't see it, unseen. It's not talking about that. Okay? What verse was that, Captain?
That was verse 7.
Go ahead.
Verse 8. And as flowers of roses in the spring of the year.
Now it's telling you like in the flowers that bud in the springtime. That's how, which is the beginning of what? Spring. The beginning of what? Spring. Right, of the year. Spring is the beginning of the year. So now he's comparing. So what correlation does that have with the moon? The moon dictates the beginning of the what? Month. Did somebody say year? Lord, Lord. We only get one moon in a year. Daggone. Give me Job 31:26. Wait, hold on. I thought I got something. What'd you say? Jump down to verse 11.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 50, verse
11.
When he put on the robe of honor and was clothed with the perfection of glory.
That's it. And was clothed with the perfection of glory, like when the moon decreases in her what? Perfection. It's all going to, it's the same thing, same context. That's all.
Exactly. All praises. So from there, let's go to Job 31:26.
Book of Job, chapter 31, verse 26. If I beheld the sun when it shined, or the moon walking in brightness.
Or the moon walking in brightness. This, so we got to see how the Most High deals and explains. The Bible's going to explain to you the moon. You don't got to be searching Esau's books, although I did do that too. But the Bible is the ultimate. From there, was that the whole verse?
Yes, sir.
Give me Isaiah 30, 26. We just read Job 31, 26. So now we're going to Isaiah 30.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 26.
Now, I know I have some people online right now angry, mad as hell, but you're going to be all right, brother or sister. All you need is a biblical scripture to give proof the moon is black. That's all you need. When it's new. That's all you need. So far, we've been reading brightness, light, and its perfection. That's what we've been reading. We even read this: how the moon, the circuit begins. Is light, then it decreases, then increases. And if you can't, Sirach 43 is heavy. Yeah. That one right there says it all.
That was the one that did it for me.
And if you can't see that, there's something wrong spiritually. So where we at?
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 26.
Isaiah 30 and verse 26. Very good. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 26. Moreover, the light of the moon.
Now, hold on. Let me fill it in for you. This is talking about the kingdom. The kingdom. Now, just read. I'm going to explain it. Go ahead.
Moreover, the light of the moon shall be as the light of the sun.
So in the kingdom, the light of the moon shall be as bright as the sun. Go ahead.
And the light of the sun shall be sevenfold.
And light of the moon shall be sevenfold, seven times brighter than what it is. Go ahead.
As the light of 7 days.
Like you gather 7 days of light and put it in the sun. That's how bright it is. Go ahead.
In the day that the Lord bindeth up the breach of his people and healeth the stroke of their wound.
So when is that? When is he going to heal us? In the kingdom. When we come up out of captivity, we're in the kingdom. So it's telling you in the kingdom, the moon shall be as bright as the sun, and the sun shall be seven times brighter. But let's find out exactly when. Read on.
Verse 27. Behold, the name of the Lord cometh from far.
This is referring to Christ. Remember it said, and his name is called what? His name is called what, brothers? Can you give me that scripture? Because some of them don't know. Revelation 19, around 10 or 13, somewhere there, I'm guessing. Yes.
A giant tetragram is not going to come out burning anything. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. This actual name is not, or title is not going to come out of nowhere burning stuff. It's referring to his son here.
You got it? Is it verse 10 or 13? Something like
13.
That.
13.
Okay, come on.
The book of Revelations, chapter 19, verse 13. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God.
This is all making reference to Christ. So let's go back to Isaiah 30.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 27. Mm-hmm. Behold, the name of the Lord cometh from far.
So this is talking about Christ, just like Revelation 19. Go ahead.
Burning with his anger, and the burden thereof is heavy. His lips are full of indignation, and his tongue as a devouring fire.
So Isaiah is explaining when Christ comes, going to be great destruction. Go ahead.
And his breath, as an overflowing stream, shall reach to the midst of the neck.
He's going to kill a lot of people. Go ahead.
To sift the nations with the sieve of vanity.
You know, like when you farm and you got that instrument, what is it called? That sickle, right, thank you. It's like in Revelation, is it 14 or 6, where it tells you about the sickle. He's going to thrash the nations. So here is giving you an analogy of that in abbreviation. Go ahead, read again. And his breath?
And his breath, as an overflowing stream, shall reach to the midst of the neck to sift the nations with the sieve of vanity.
Vanity, because the nations are useless. Go ahead.
And there shall be a bridle in the jaws of the people, causing them to err.
Meaning causing them to fight. Christ is going to make those nations come and fight against them. Like it says in 2 Esdras, it says they were afraid, but yet they durst fight. Right. They're going to want to, it's chapter 13, 2 Esdras 13. They're going to want to fight Christ, because he's going to make them fight. Why? So that he can show his power. And all the world is going to give honor and praise to him. Read.
Verse 29. Ye shall have a song as in the night, when a holy solemnity is kept.
When is a holy, what is a holy solemnity? What is a holy solemnity? Huh? A feast day. A feast day, a high holy day. So on this, when Christ destroys the nations, verse 29, one more time.
Ye shall have a song, as in the night when a holy solemnity is kept, and gladness of heart, as when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel.
So we are, when are we going? Is this going to be? When is this going to be? Here in America or on the kingdom? It's going to be in the kingdom. Now jump back to verse 26 to show you what it's going to be like in the night of your solemnities.
Moreover, the light of the moon shall be as the light of the sun.
So on the feast days in the kingdom, the light of the moon shall be bright as the sun. So wait a minute. So if it's going to be bright as the sun in the kingdom, what are we talking about now with the black moon? It's called being deceived. The white man, in case y'all didn't know, let me help you. The white man's the devil.
That's right.
Just letting you know that. And I'm not saying it just because it makes my teeth white. I'm saying it because it's true. The Bible says, in the days of our solemnity, our high holy days, the moon shall be as bright as the sun. Do y'all see that? Do y'all see that? Alaba, y'all see that? Okay. All right. Now, I just want to make sure. Good. Now, give me Baruch 6 and 60. Baruch 6 and 60.
The book of Baruch, chapter 6, verse 60. For sun, moon, and stars, being bright and sent to do their offices, are obedient.
Y'all see that? They are bright. The sun, the moon. Read it again.
For sun.
Moon.
And stars. Being bright.
Being, what's that word, brothers?
Bright.
Go ahead.
And sent to do their offices.
So what is the office? Listen good. What is the office of the new moon? I see this hand already.
Y'all should know this. Think about the scriptures that we went over.
Let me hear this brother on the far left with the black pen in his hand. Yeah, you. Yes. What is the office? So they were sent to do their office.
They should get it.
Shalom. Brother.
What's your name?
Brother Nathaniel.
So you know what this means. He better not mess up.
New moon is a sign of our feast days.
Very good. The new moon is a sign of our feast days. And what else?
Sign of the first day of the month.
Very good. First day of the month. Very good.
Yeah, the pressure was on them.
The pressure was on. Do you men understand that?
Yes, sir.
So, Captain Ryan, can you read that one more time? Baruch 6 and 60 is heavy.
The book of Baruch, chapter 6, verse 60. For sun, moon, and stars being bright and sent to do their offices.
So the moon will be bright in its office. Go ahead.
Are obedient.
Yeah, yes, Lava.
Yeah, read that again.
For sun, moon, and stars being bright and sent to do their offices are obedient.
When they do their offices, they're in their glory. They're not doing their office while they're in the dark.
Right. That is the point right there. So it's easy. It shuts foolishness down. It shut us down. I had the mindset, okay, the moon is dark. Now, where's the dark moon, new moon scriptures? Right.
Exactly.
I can't find them. Now, they are. I'm going to show you some real quick. Let me show you. Anytime, listen good, y'all can write this down. Anytime when the Bible talks about the moon being dark, it's talking about judgment coming upon the earth. Watch this. Give me Joel 2 and 10. Now, these scriptures we're about to read talks about the moon being dark, which is making a reference to judgment, not holy solemnities. Everybody understand that? Okay, I want no confusion up in here. Go ahead.
The book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 10. The earth shall shake. The earth shall quake before them. The heavens shall tremble. The sun and the moon shall be dark.
Oh, high holy day.
That ain't talking about a high holy day. This is talking about great judgment upon the earth. Go ahead.
And the stars shall withdraw their shining.
You see, y'all see that this is judgment. When the sun and the moon withdraw their light. And the moon, and the stars don't bring forth. I'm getting all mixed up. And the stars don't bring forth their light. Thank you. Now, give me another one. Give me Joel 3:15.
The book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 15. The sun and the moon shall be darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shining.
Judgment again. Now give me Matthew 24 and 29. Judgment.
The book of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light.
New moon. New moon. No, brother, that's not the new moon. This is talking about judgment. Go ahead.
And the stars shall fall from heaven.
Uh-huh.
And the powers of the heavens shall be shaken.
And the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. Now, let me see. Give me Revelation 8 and 12.
The book of Revelation, chapter 8, verse 12. And the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten, and the third part of the moon.
Third part of the moon? Crescent moon. New moon. No, brother, this is talking about judgment. Judgment upon the earth. Go ahead.
And the third part of the stars. So as the third part of them was darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it, and the night likewise.
So now let's see what happened. Why did we always believe the new moon was dark? Daniel 7:25. Y'all know this one.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High.
The he here is the so-called white man, beginning with Babylon, which is America, followed by her allies, which is Britain and the European Union. Go ahead. That's the he. Go ahead.
And shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
He wore us out in slavery. He wore us out from our nationality, our identity. He destroyed us mentally, spiritually, economically, militarily. He destroyed us. He wore us out. Go ahead.
And think to change times and laws.
Now, that's the part we want to look at. And think to this man, the he, Esau, would think to change times and laws. Now, we always explain how Esau changed the beginning of the new year. He said, it's not spring like God says. He said, it's winter, January 1st. He says, the beginning of a day is 12 midnight. Not like God says at sundown, but at midnight. Now we're realizing, right, he changed the Sabbath from the seventh day to the first day. He also did daylight savings time. Thank you. Spring, you go ahead 1 hour, move the clock ahead 1 hour. And fall, you fall back 1 hour. Everybody familiar with that? Now we're finding out that he did something else with the moon. He changed the brightness of the moon to the dark moon. It threw everything off by the difference of like 15 days. 15-day difference.
Yeah, you notice that when is the full moon come, he speak very evil of it. He said the day is bad. That's when all evil happening. Because he's trying to escape, he's trying to make us run away from the sign that Lord give us in the full moon. So he speak much evil. When the scripture said, you have to know that that man you're dealing with. He said that man is a man of sin. What light Esau have? There is no light in Esau. He's there for darkness.
He's the polar opposite. He's adverse.
Right.
That's why it says in verse 25, it says, he shall speak great words against the Most High, against the Sabbath. Against time, the day, the year, and the moon. Against everything.
Hey,
it says, think to change times and laws. The Most High is going to reveal to us that's wrong. That's not the case.
I want to dwell on something that Deacon Lava said because y'all heard that term. They said it must be a full moon out and all the witches and goblins and all that other stuff. Huh? They always try to make it seem evil. That's the trickery of this dude, this so-called white man. But the Most High said, how are the hidden things of Esau searched out? The waters are rising. So you those know. Things are being brought out.
Yeah, exactly. You know
it's
this.
It's going to piss him off. He's going to be mad as hell. Mm-hmm. Y'all get ready for it.
You already see the camps attacking.
Yep.
Our own people. No. Attack. Just like with the hexagram, the same spirit. Bishop, Esau said, just sit back. The own people going to attack him first.
Bishop, you notice that he attacked in us the way to win us back home.
Mm-hmm.
The new moon, the days, the feast days. To win us back to the Lord, he attacked all that. Trying to keep us away from the truth. That was his job from the beginning. Yep. To keep us away from the truth.
Exactly. Get Isaiah 29, 15 and 16.
Isaiah 29, chapter and the 15 verse. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from
Woe
the Lord.
Woe unto him. That's the him here is the white man. Your friendly neighborhood white man. Esau. Read that again.
Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord.
From the Lord. So the white man, your friend, sought to hide his counsel from the Lord. And he did that in slavery. Go ahead.
And their works are in the dark.
They did that when we were in the dark. I mean, when we was in captivity, that's why he made sure we could not read, we could not write. That's why they did that thing, so that we could never come against them spiritually. Go ahead.
And they say, who seeth us?
Who seeth us? God's people ain't seeing us because we've brought them so low they can't read or write. They can't correct us. Go ahead.
And who knoweth us?
Who's going to even know that we are the devil the Bible speaks of? Who knoweth us? Go ahead.
Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as potter's clay.
The white man turned everything upside down. The beginning of the year, the beginning of the month, everything he's changed upside down. But God said it shall be esteemed as the potter's clay.
So how did the Most High esteem it as the potter's clay? How did he do it? He says, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. How did he do it? We read it earlier. I see one hand in the back. One hand in the back. Get my brother in the back. Stick your hand up again. How did he do it?
Because even though it was made by Esau, it could always be remolded back into the truth.
That's not what... That ain't the answer. How did he do it? Read the scripture says, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay. How is it being esteemed as the potter's clay? We read it earlier, and I'm after this, I'm gonna answer it. My brother right here with the gray sweat thing on.
So like as clay, it's gonna break.
No, you know. Okay, I'm gonna get the answer. Romans, we read it, that thou mightest be justified in thy sins. He's being esteemed because the correction is in the Bible. That's the answer, because we're reading it. Because without this, all of the things that he turned upside down will remain upside down. But it is because of the correction in the Bible, that's what's turning it right side up. Like the days of the year. How do we find out where the year begins? Because the Bible has it. How do we find out about when the years begin and when the months begin? Because of the new moon. We're finding out because it's in the Bible. That thou mightest be justified in thy sayings. That's how we are justified in correcting it.
No prayer. I'm going to give you another one to add to that. Go to Deuteronomy 33:17.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 17. His glory is like the firstling of the bullocks.
Wait, real quick. I'm sorry. Give me verse 29.
Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 29. Happy art thou, O Israel, who is like unto thee, O people saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellency. And thy enemies shall be found liars unto thee.
That surely your things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay. They're being found out that they're liars. How? The Bible. Everybody understand that? Read that bottom part again, Captain.
And thy enemies shall be found liars unto thee. And thou shalt tread upon their high places.
Exactly. We're going to tread upon their kingdom. Destroy their kingdoms.
Bishop.
Yes.
You forgot. Include the Hebrew.
The what?
He's changing thing upside down. Include
the Hebrew. Yes, that's you're right. He changed the Hebrew too. Exactly. Yeah, and remind me in a few minutes. I'm gonna touch on it just for a second. Give me that. Stay right there in that chapter, Deuteronomy 33 about Ephraim, verse 13 and 14.
Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 13.
Add this to the scriptures about the new moon is the full moon. Add this one. I forgot. Just popped in my head.
Deuteronomy, the 33rd chapter and the 13th verse. And of Joseph, he said, blessed of the Lord be his land for the precious things of heaven.
Because in his land is Puerto Rico. Then you have Cuba as well. It says, for the precious things, read that part again.
And of Joseph, he said, blessed of the Lord be his land for the precious things of heaven.
Come on.
For the dew and for the deep that couch it beneath.
Because beneath the seas of Puerto Rico and Cuba, you have riches down there. Read.
Verse 14. And for the precious fruits brought forth by the sun.
So precious fruits are brought forth by the sun. Go ahead.
And for the precious things put forth by the moon.
Y'all see that? So they're precious things brought forth by the moon. When it's what, brothers? Full or shining. Not when it's dark. The plants don't react to the moon in the dark. Like in many of the Caribbean islands. Agriculture is done, the best agriculture is done during the time of what? The full moon. Y'all from the island should know that. We in the city, we shouldn't know that. But y'all should know that. No one can hear you say it.
Said the moon also affects the tide.
Exactly. Very good. The moon affects the tide as well, yes.
In Puerto Rico, during the full moon, you have that precious frog that comes out only on the full moon.
Right.
It's called the coqui.
Right, the coqui. That's right. The little green thing. So now, Ms. Brown, give me Numbers 28, 11 through 15. These were the sacrifices that were done every new moon. I'm just going to tidy up on. Oh, I'm sorry. You said something about the Hebrew. Right, includes the Hebrew. Give me that real quick. Is it Zechariah? You know what I'm talking about, Captain?
Yep.
Zephaniah. I always get them two Z's mixed up. Zephaniah, Zechariah. It should be Zephaniah 3, 8, something like that.
The book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger. For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. For then will I turn to the people a pure language.
After he destroys and smites the nations, he said, for then shall I turn to the people a pure tongue. Go ahead.
That they may all call upon the name of the Lord, to serve him with one consent.
So he's going to give us that pure tongue. When, brothers? Right. After this place is destroyed, we're in the kingdom. From the wilderness to the kingdom. So you got brothers fighting over the Hebrew today.
But they don't understand English.
Yeah, exactly.
Read verse 9 again.
For then, where
I turn. Hold it. What does for then means? Thank you.
Exactly. Exactly. So now we get little Hebrew names, but we don't put full confidence in the little Hebrew names we got. Because we know it's impure. Like even my name, Nathaniel. That is not the pure tongue. The Most High is going to give it to us. Just like the name Yahweh. We know the Lord gave Moses, Yahweh. He gave Abraham and Isaac. What was the name he gave them? Alashadja. We ain't arguing over that. Because we know we're going to get the pure tongue when the Lord returns. Everybody understand that? Yes, fight over the Hebrew, brother.
If they can't understand this verse 9, I'm still tripping on for then, meaning for at that time, he will do it.
Exactly.
And what time is it talking about? Verse 8 told you the time, when he bring on the wrath of the nations and all that.
Exactly.
That has not happened yet. So what is wrong with people? Then you're trying to break down the deep stuff to them and they can't even see this.
Exactly. So what are you going to say?
Imagine they're on the street teaching, right? And they're teaching the people and they're saying, Yahweh Shai or Yeshua. A lot of people don't know what that name is. You gotta explain to them after, listen, Yahweh Shai, that's talking about Jesus Christ. So they still gotta say the name. You understand? So don't matter how they look at it, they still gotta say that name, Jesus Christ. You understand?
Exactly. Get numbers 28:11 through 15. So this is what we did on the new moon. On the new moon, back in during the time of Moses, I'm gonna jump back there real quick.
The book of Numbers, chapter 28.
We're gonna read 11 through 15.
Verse 11. And in the beginning of your months, ye shall offer a burnt offering unto the Lord.
So when it says, notice it says, and in the beginning of your months. The beginning of your months. That ties in with Sirach 43, where it says the word month is after the name moon. You are familiar with that? So read on.
And in the beginnings of your months, you shall offer a burnt offering unto the Lord, two young bullocks and one ram, seven lambs of the first year without spot, the 3/10 deals of flour for a meat offering mingled with oil for one bullock, and 2/10 deals of flour for meat offering mingled with oil for one ram, and several 10th deal of flour mingled with oil for meat, for a meat offering unto one lamb.
So every new moon, which was the beginning of your months, we sacrifice. Read.
For a burnt offering of a sweet savior, a sacrifice made by fire unto the Lord. And their drink offering shall be half a hin of wine unto a bullock, and a third part of a hin unto a ram, and a fourth part of a hin unto a lamb. This is the burnt offering of every month throughout the months of the year. And one kid of goat for a sin offering unto the Lord shall be offered, beside the continual burnt offering and his drink offering.
So now you see that with the month. That was on our new moons. That's what we did. When you jump up in the chapter, verse 9 and 10 talks about the Sabbath. Read that.
Verse 9. And on the Sabbath day, two lambs of the first year without spot, and 2/10 deals of flour for a meat offering, mingled with oil, and the drink offering thereof. This is the burnt offering of every Sabbath, beside the continual burnt offering and his drink offering.
So y'all see, we did burnt offerings and drink offerings on the Sabbath as well as the new moon, which was the beginning of our months. Y'all see that, right? So that's what explains Colossians 2:16 now. This is why Paul, when Christ came, he sacrificed his life. Israel was arguing, do we still need to do sacrifices or just go into Christ? That was the argument. Because you had the Pharisees judging those Israelites that followed Christ strictly. And this is what Paul said regarding those Israelites that was always arguing. Now you got to go back and do burnt offerings and sin offerings on the Sabbath days and the new moons. This is what he says. Read that.
The book of Colossians chapter 2, verse 16. Let no man therefore judge you in
meat. The men at that time judging were the scribes and Pharisees. Read. Let no man therefore judge you
in meat.
In meat offerings. That's what we just read in Numbers 28.
Or in drink.
Drink offerings. That's what we just read in Numbers 28.
Or in respect of a holy day.
Because on the holy days, the way you gave it respect was by doing what, brothers? Sacrifice. Burnt offerings and drink offerings. Read.
Or of the new moon.
What do we do in the new moons? We gave burnt offerings and drink offerings. Read.
Or of the Sabbath days.
What do we do on the Sabbath days? Drink offerings and meat offerings. Everybody understand that? Read.
Verse 17. Which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ.
We're under Christ. Christ fulfilled all that. Because the laws back then were a shadow of things to come, which means makes reference to who, brothers? Christ. That's why John the Baptist said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world. Okay? Give me that Hebrews, is it 10 and 1? What talks about the shadow? 11 and 1? 10 and 1? Read.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 1. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come.
For the law having a shadow of good things to come. Go ahead.
And not the very image of the thing can never with those sacrifices which they offer year by year continually make the comers thereunto perfect.
So it says the law which was a shadow of things to come is talking about Christ. That's why when you jump down, read the verse where it says, but a body. I'm not looking at him. Trust you, find it for me.
Verse 5. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he said, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared me.
Now, right under that somewhere, it talks about Jesus Christ died once for all, somewhere right under there. 11?
Verse 10.
Okay.
By the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
Y'all see that? So he was fulfillment of burnt offerings, drink offerings. It was all fulfilled in Christ. That's why Paul said, don't let no man judge you. Don't worry about the scribes and the Pharisees always gainsaying, oh, you guys got to go back and sacrifice or else the Lord ain't going to accept you. Paul said, don't listen to that. That's wrong. So likewise today, you got to, it's the same spirit.
Psalms 81 verse 3.
The book of Psalms 81 verse 3. Mm-hmm. Blow up the trumpet in the new moon. In the time appointed on your solemn feast day.
Now that new moon will be talking about the full moon. The time appointed is still talking about the full moon. Okay, on our solemn feast day, which are full moons. But here's where brothers are being crafty. Read the next verses.
Wait a minute, Deacon, real quick. How do you appoint the time if you can't see the moon?
Listen, I was saving that one. How could you appoint the time? Who went outside and looked and saw blackness and said, there go the moon right there in the dark?
Right, and by the time you realize okay. that, it's already passed.
And by the time you realize that, it's past, you idiot. Okay?
Read on. Verse 5.
Verse 4. For this was a statue for Israel and a law of the God of Jacob.
So it was appointed for Israel to blow up the trumpet on the new moon, when the time appointed, which is the new moon, on our solemn feast day. Go ahead.
This he ordained in Joseph for a testimony.
Still referring to Israel. Go ahead.
When he went out through the land of Egypt.
Go ahead.
Where I heard a language that I understood not.
Go ahead.
I removed the shoulder from the burden. His hands were delivered from the pots. Thou callest in trouble, and I delivered thee. I answered thee in the secret place of thunder.
The wilderness.
I proved thee at the waters of Meribah.
So he's going into when he spoke to Israel and gave them these orders. He gave Israel commandments when they were in Egypt. Right? Yeah, right? He gave Israel commandments when they were in Egypt. Now, it says, blow the trumpet in the new moon, the time appointed on our solemn feast day. Go to Exodus 12 and 1. Let's see when he gave that order. He gave Israel their first month. When Israel dwelt in Egypt, and he gave them, they had a 10-day week. Egypt didn't have the same calendar as we had. The Lord gave them our calendar as we were leaving out of there. Exodus 12 and verse 1.
The book of Exodus, chapter 12, verse 1.
Watch this.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt.
Where are we?
In the land of Egypt, saying,
go ahead.
This month shall be unto you the beginning of months.
What would determine that's the beginning of our month? What would we use? The moon. Yeah,
that's right.
The full moon. That's when we left. And we use that to determine when we will keep Passover. Read on.
It shall be the first month of the year.
Because in Egypt, the calendar was different. The Lord said, listen, this month right here you're in is the beginning of your months. And that will be your full moon. So from this month on, you keep this feast. That's what David was talking about, or whoever was, I think it was Asaph, was talking about in Psalms 81. Not rather saying, oh, well, your doctrine's confusing because the full moon falls in Passover. No, it does not. There's no scripture that says that when Israel kept the Passover, it was a full moon. That's not in the Bible. Israel used the full moon to determine their feast days. Don't be simple. You brothers are young and dumb as hell and try to challenge us that you're book smart. Stop doing it. Stop it. It happens. Brothers who've done it have left and failed. I'm going to tell you straight up. If you don't understand and you still understand these scriptures, you got to go. You brothers got to go. Don't text me no more. Just go start your own thing.
Leave.
Use
just
your
go,
book smartness, man. Whatever the hell it is you do, and move on with your life, man. But Psalms 81 is referring to the Most High gave Moses the time when their months began. And that is a full moon. The time appointed is the new moon, which is a full moon. That was the beginning of our months, based upon Ecclesiastes 43. And period. That's it.
And that cycle cannot.
And I don't need Hebrew to understand that. It's clear in English. The men that translated the Bible into English were Hebrew scholars that spoke Hebrew fluently, not Heblish, Hebrew English. They didn't do all of that. They spoke the language. They could ask me how my day was in fluent Hebrew. They could ask what time it is
in fluent Hebrew. Not go, hey, brother, when you go to the blue letter, that's a novice tool. Blue letter is a tool for a novice. The King James translators were scholars. They were scholars of universities who spoke Hebrew from the time of the age of six. These men can't speak no damn Hebrew. Do not take them seriously. Anyone coming with a strong concordance breakdown, dismiss them. Let's, you know what? For the fun of it, let's use blue letter. Let's go.
Wait. No. We got to do like Christ from now on. Remember when Christ spoke to the Pharisees and he said, now go find out what that means? That's right. How we got to start treating these people.
Okay, let me do that then.
Okay, save some of the stuff for when real scoffers come that we got to hand them they behind. Don't start throwing everything out because they're not going to take it and digest it and say, you're right. They're doing just what they do as scoffing Negroes. They're just running their mouth because they can. So, like I was telling the men, some of the information we have to retain it until we're in a real war. When we got to cut down people that matter. You Negroes don't matter that's running your mouth. Okay? That's how Christ spoke. He spoke to the Pharisees and he would tell them, now go find out what that means.
Right.
Christ wouldn't explain himself. And the scriptures tell you, more things are shown unto you than men understand. So a lot of our explanations are a waste of time. We're going to give you the basics, the milk.
Right.
Hey, Deacon Asaph, and the reason why Christ did that a lot of times is to get rid of the unbelievers.
Exactly.
You understand? So exactly. this understanding that the Most High gave unto us is the next level. And he also gave it, if you don't understand it, you understand, if the understanding came out and you fighting against it, guess what? That's the Most High getting rid of you. You understand? It tell you when Christ spoke, Christ used to speak things hard to be understood because he knows some of the people amongst him didn't believe. You understand? So he said things to cause people to leave because he know they don't believe, so he know they're gonna get offended and they're gonna leave. You understand? But read Psalms 119 and 18. Read that for me. Because the understanding that the Most High is revealing unto us is the Most High opening our eyes to see these things. You understand? It's not just we getting up and we, that's what the scripture. No, the Most High is taking our understanding to another level. Read
the book of Psalms 119, verse 18. Open thou my eyes.
Do what?
Open thy my eyes.
So this is what we got to ask the Most High, to open our eyes. All right, read on.
That I may behold wondrous things out of thy law.
And the wondrous things is what we just bring out about the new moon. The Most High opened our eyes for us to understand that the new moon, how we was following it, was wrong. You understand? So these brothers that's bucking against it is because the Most High have not opened their eyes to understand it.
Exactly.
You know, so you brothers that out there want to go fight with them, trying to show them scriptures, listen, these men is not going to get it. Because some people, the Most High going to just put a stumbling block before them. You understand? This is going to be a stumbling block for some brothers. Even brothers amongst us. You understand? This is going to be a stumbling block for them, for them to fall. You understand?
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.